I wonder what this would do. Trickery? Amulets, you say? I believe I have them already. Here, you see? Oh, we took them. Let me have those. Yes, they're perfect. They're... No. What treachery is this? Amulet of the Keeper of Scroll Secrets under the mountain. I said I needed all 5 amulets, and this is what you give me? You try to cheat Coldhearth, Abathor's hand on Toril? You will pay for this, mortal. Pay for it with your life. Okay, I didn't make a connection between the amulets there. Alright.
Huh?
Attack. And then we've got...
Trouble?
This thing. I guess I have to... put it there.
Aye.
Make him more vulnerable. When a lich says it wants 5 amulets, it is wisest to give it no less than 5 amulets. Is that a journal entry? My missed fortune. No, that's not it. Yeah. Oh, he's already injured. Did he even cast that yet? No, he didn't even cast it yet, and the lich is injured.
And? What is it?
This guy's toast. Alright, Minsk is blocked. What is this? Oh, goblin warriors. We can't control them.
Do it. In a tick.
What? Such menial tasks.
He's badly injured.
Yeah, it's time for-
but I think Mince needs to get closer to use that.
You want more?
Oh, he did use it. Evidently. Specific projection dispelled, combat projections dispelled, miscast magic. One of the spells has failed. Alright.
What?
Well, now you can just hit him.
I hear. Yes?
I should do this. Oh, I can't control the chieftains.
What? Speak.
Actually, just in case, let's cast silence on him.
Trouble.
Spell ineffective. Okay, we got an ancient key and the amulet I gave him. Patches of flaking rust obscure the intricate designs that once adorned the head of this ancient corroded key. It says I must find the Coldhard Lich's phylactery. I have hurt the lich, but I cannot destroy it utterly until I find and destroy its phylactery. It must be somewhere in the area. Alright. We should do that quickly.
Hurry! I will.
Yeah, exactly, hurry. Should we all go in? I don't know if he's...
Sword first!
If he's gonna come back in this chamber, or is going to be here with the phylactery. We need to turn these, huh? two of them.
All right. Trouble?
You turn that one.
Yeah?
You turn this one. You're too far away to examine that. Okay.
Aye. Sword first.
You go there.
I will.
You go there. Can't see that the others can be turned. Alright, they can't move.
Yeah, sword first.
This is ridiculous.
You want? Let's talk more fight.
Yeah, let's talk more going over there.
What? In a tick.
All right.
What?
Turn that.
Do it. Trouble.
Turn that. An intricate carving of a rose with a long thorny stem wraps around the surface of this lacquered burgundy box. The carefully crafted piece seems heavier than it ought. The word phylactery, spelled wrong, has been crudely carved upon the surface of this rough-hewn stone cube. When you pick it up, something rattles within, but there is no obvious way to access the contents short of shattering the box. Well, I don't know which... Oh, there's... Now we can interact with the others.
Hurry!
Alright. Turn this... into melee. It's grayed out, though. Is it in melee use? Melee,
huh?
Hmm. How do I break it?
Trouble?
Yeah?
You hit the box, which collapses into splinters. A cloud of warm, moist air envelops you momentarily. With a sigh, it dissipates into the chamber's murk. And then with McKinn's, with some effort, you dash the box to pieces. A small piece of parchment bearing the word soul is left in your hand.
Hmm?
Soul? Well, I guess we have to use a key on one of them. Who's got the parchment? I don't see that anyone has it. Okay, I'm not sure, so...
What? I will.
Aye, let's talk more fight!
Do it.
Yes.
At first glance, this brass amulet appears to be wrapped in chains of the same material. Closer inspection reveals that the chains are molded along the surface of the charm. Just break everything, I say.
You want boo?
A small fortune of precious stones is set in a large fortune of gold and silver, formed in the shape of a box. Wrapped around the box is a long cord of supple material made of the hide of some exotic beast. Okay.
Drop
that. Hit that. Smashing the amulet reveals a glittering blue diamond concealed within. That's the Goblin Chieftain.
What?
Did he do his? Though seemingly composed of malleable precious metals, the phylactery resists all attempts to damage it. Destroying it may require power beyond the prime material plane. The portal, the damaged portal to the elemental plane of fire, I believe. Well, I have this. Cold Hearth Phylactery. Cool. And that's the same description. Now, I wonder, though, if there are other... There might be more to destroy.
Huh? Yes.
Hurry.
I can't move that.
Yeah? In a tick.
Trouble?
Hmm? What in a tick?
He's in the way.
Do it.
This modest, unadorned wooden box is tied shut with a string of leather. That's Minsk's. And, McKinn's has a medallion in the shape of an elven skull hangs from a golden chain, small green gems glittering in its eye sockets. The skull is apparently hollow. Shaking it produces a barely audible rustling from within. Alright, let's destroy these two.
Aye.
The wooden box is easily smashed to splinters. A small piece of parchment concealed within drops to the floor and instantly crumbles to dust. Huh. I wonder if we could have, like, looted. I mean, there's no option to do anything but just click the interact thing. Wait, what about the other one? Oh, you crush the golden elf skull. The gems in its eye sockets fall to the floor. Falling to the floor?
Yes. Sword first.
I'm not seeing anything that we can pick up. Alright, let's run to here. The broken portal to the other planes. We throw the phylactery in there. I don't know if he's going to come back and attack us. I think it's likely.
You want Boo?
I want destroy phylactery. What about the key? What's the key for? I'm still hasted, thank God. Running up. Okay, quickest way through is just the hallway and then straight through. Well, here we have to go down that way, actually. I'd be surprised if that's a door we can get through. Is McKinn not hasty? Oh boy. Spell's running out. Golem is gone, and the others will be gone as well. And haste wore off. Please don't wander off. Who's got it? Minsk. That was just perfect. We've got things to fight. Can we just throw this in first? You guys stand by a second.
Huh?
I have to... I think I just lick it. We got salamanders? Or fire salamanders? Chain contingency. I guess that's him back there. He still has it.
Trouble?
The image of a fiery landscape appears, accompanied by a blast of unearthly heat. You realize that it was in such a place as this that the Cold Hearth's Lich phylactery was formed. Okay, can we just throw it in and then fight these things? You cast the golden box down into the flames. As it falls, the metal turns molten, its surface bubbling and sloughing off. The soul within screams. And something. Oh, here it is. The soul within screams in rage and fear as the fire consumes it. Awesome. And this guy's screaming, "No! I'll see you dead for this! I'll flay the soul from your body! Your miseries will be legend across all the plains." Your suffering will be legendary, even in hell? Alright, so...
Aye.
Minsk is very busy. Now he casts that on it. Hopefully not on the door. I don't know what we should do about the salamanders right now. I wonder if we can paralyze them.
What is it?
See if they can be paralyzed. I don't know. I'll try to paralyze that one.
I called.
And she'll try to paralyze this one.
Yes, I will.
He's casting things. Are we already. We don't have silence. Do you have silence? I think you might. I'm not seeing silence here. All right, how about calling a woodland being.
I am yours to command.
I guess just stand by. Attack it for now.
Your need?
Arrows of biting. Don't have very many of them. They help interrupt with spellcasting.
Death comes swiftly!
Okay. Now, I'm waiting to see... Fire Salamander is stunned. I don't know. They cast, and I don't think...
Yes?
I don't think it worked. Let's just try to take out this guy, I guess.
Yes?
Yes?
Actually, she still has this. Melf's minute meteors.
Well,
she ran out of that.
I demand?
Ouch.
Done and done. And whatever comes.
Oh boy.
Yes.
I hear. I shall. Back hold.
Oh, did he die? Oh, sweet. Wow. 22,000 experience. All right, let's kill these things.
You want Boo?
Yes?
You keep taking potions.
What?
Hey there.
Hurry.
This is the end for you.
Oh, we're slowing down. I don't know why that is. I finished my dealings with Coldhearth. The Coldhearth Lich did not deal well with my challenging its authority. It dealt with me destroying its phylactery, followed by its wretched existence even worse.
By demand?
Oh boy. I'm wondering what's running. Hold on. I want to see if I can get out to the desktop and see if something is running in the background. If I don't lose this. Okay, I closed a few processes. Hopefully that fix things. Not yet. I can't really save and reload right now.
Fall down now.
Fall down now.
What?
Your life should be.
Okay, one down. Excellent. Cold. I don't have very many of them. Oh, that's Minsk. Oh. Yeah, he has plenty. But you can have more.
Yes?
Sorry about this, guys. I don't know why it's running so slow.
Jalbir and Poss.
What is it?
Nice. And level up time.
Done and done.
When they sword first.
Let's get out of this room before more come. Oh, the nymph is here. I've completely forgot about the nymph. Yeah, I don't wanna mess with anything. Maybe there's an issue with summoning the nymph? I wouldn't think it's so many figures at once, because we've had way more than that. Leveling up time?
You want me?
Yeah, close that.
Yes, dear.
Close that door. Okay, now let me restore my save.
Whatever you like.
Here we go. Oh, the nymph's healing us. Awesome. Anyway. Mass cure. Awesome. You can't talk to it. What a shame. Someone needs a little more curing.
Yeah?
Yeah. The kin's cheering. That's awesome. Alright. Vaconia. Additional level 1, 2, and 5 spells. 7 more hit points and will increase by an entire point. Can you imagine? Sweet. So she... That's funny. Hit points 50. There it is. 50 hit points. Nice and even. And then... New spell. More. Okay, another level 1. Remove fear. Thinking in a pinch, more remove fear. Cure light is starting to become less helpful. We should buy more potions soon, though. Regular potions, that is, anyway. And the others, just extra healing if we can find it. Alright, so we already have chant, silence, resist fire and cold, 2 slow poisons. Draw upon holy might. Strength, constitution, dexterity are all raised by 1 point. So by 3 points at level 9, which I think that's what she's at. Yes. I don't know. Strength, con, and dexterity. So, it gives us some extra hit points. Better, melee and ranged attacks, but... Do I really use her for that very often? She only has 50 hit points. Yeah, I'll take it. Just in case if everything else is out, send her into melee, just have her cast that first. Hopefully I do remember. Just gotta find it now. Here we go. Okay, so now she can cast level 5 spells. Animal summoning 2. 1 to 3 animals that have 8 hit dice or less. Only normal or giant animals. Lasts for 3 turns. Cause critical wounds. Just... You have to make a touch attack. 27 damage. You could miss, though. I always say so. Champion strength. When this spells is cast, the priest effectively draws on the strength of her god and lends it to the target creature. It's in effect creating a champion. The target gains a bonus to her Thaco at a rate of 1 for every 3 levels of the caster. So a ninth level priest would confer a Thaco bonus of 3 to the target and so on. Wow. Also, the target strength is set to 1800 for the duration of the spell. Well, I cast it on Minsk if we're going to use it. I'm probably not going to use this. I mean, we only get to have one. Receives all the bonuses to hit and damage rolls. Oh, note that if the target strength is above 1800, it will actually be reduced to this value. That's no good. The drawback to this is the priest must concentrate on the connection between the target and her god for the duration of the spell, hence losing the ability to cast any spells during this time. Can she even attack during that time? The effect lasts for 3 rounds for every level of caster or until dispelled. Okay. I'm not going to use that. Especially because we have Cure Critical. That's probably what I'm going to be doing. 27 points of damage. Just a flat 27. Flame Strike. Vertical column of fire roars downward in the exact location called for by the caster. The target must roll a saving throw versus spell. Failure means the creature sustains 1d8 points of damage per level of the caster. Otherwise, the damage is half, so we have 9d8. And it looks like it's the effect is just one creature, so it's not a range, so we don't have to worry about friendly fire. At least, I don't think so. Yeah, I wish I could memorize both of them. Greater Command. As with the first level spell command, this spell enables the priest to command other creatures to die, sleep, except that the effects of this spell last 1 round per level of the caster. At the end of the round, the creatures awaken and are unharmed. The area of effect is similar to that of a stinking cloud or fireball. Alright, area of effect only, meaning 15-foot radius. Saving throw negates, of course. It'd be very powerful if there was no saving throw, could you imagine? Magic resistance. When this spell is cast, the recipient receives a resistance to all magic. The resistance conferred is 2% per level of the caster, up to a maximum of 40% at 20th level. Wow. This resistance is set so that if the target actually has more resistance than the priest would confer, it will actually lower it to the set value. I hate when they do that. The effect will last for the duration of the spell or until dispelled. Well, then make you be careful. Oh, here's Mass Cure. When casting this spell, the priest must picture the faces of her fellow party members clearly and focus on the unity of the group. Upon completion, all party members within a 15-foot radius of the caster are healed 1d8 plus 1 level per level hit points. So in her case, 9th level, 1d8 plus 9. Curing is permanent only insofar as the creature does not sustain further damage. Caused wounds will heal or can be cured, just as any normal injury. Raised dead, look at that. When the priest casts a raised dead spell, yeah, we've read this. The difference is, we can just cast this at will. Ah, so hard. Now I wish we had 3 slots. Repulse undead. This powerful spell creates waves of anti-negative energy that sweep outward from the caster. These waves disrupt any undead that attempt to attack the caster, pushing them away from this caster for several seconds. There is 1 wave per round for the duration of the spell. All undead are affected with no saving throw. Sweet. That's pretty interesting. Pushed back. But like an anti-matter. Huh. Righteous magic. There's a powerful combat spell that enhances the priest's physical prowess, transforming her into a juggernaut of destruction. The effect adds 1 temporary hit point per level of the caster, adds 1 point of strength every 3 levels of the caster to a maximum of 25, and causes every successful hit to inflict maximum damage. The effects last for the duration of the spell or until dispelled. That's pretty good too. Slay Living. Upon casting the spell, the priest has to touch an opponent in order to visit the effect upon them. An item is created upon casting. The next attack the priest make makes which must happen in the next three rounds will use the item. If the first attack misses, the item disappears and the spell is wasted. However, if the attack succeeds, the victim automatically takes 2d6 plus 9 damage. I mean, that's not that impressive, but also she must make a save versus a spell or be instantly killed. Slay Living can be dispelled if cast between the casting of this spell and the necessary attack. Alright, so I mean, if you cast something else. And then, True Seeing. Instantly and once each round for one turn after True Seeing is cast, all hostile illusion and phantasm spells in a 120-foot radius around the caster will be dispelled. The spells affected are a reflected image, invisibility, mirror image, not detection, improved invisibility, shadow door, mislead, project, image, and simulacrum. The target's magic resistance, if any, does not affect this. Well, how many of these scrolls do we still have? Oh, we got a diamond from that. And a black opal. We still have this key. Still the King's Tears. Did I read this? Oh, that's a gem, actually. Yeah, I read that. And an emerald. So we found a bunch of gems from this lich. So we only used this thing twice. Oh wait, he still has it. He still has it. Alright. Hopefully we get to keep it. You don't know, we might come across a lich again. I certainly hope not, though. Okay. Alright, so I was wondering how many of these we have. Three. Doesn't someone else have a few? Let me put this away. Oh. That's myself. I guess we have three. Alright, so I'll... So since we have three of these, you know what, in case Viconia is the one killed, give one to McKinn. Give one to Minsk, too. I guess we can all raise each other and stuff.